This was a low point in my career. I'd gone from a split personality manifested by five clowns to a yellow and black edgelord and his overly insane personification of unhealthy obsession with children's books. I'd hit rock bottom. Again. And it was at times like these that I turned to my usual drug of choice, my Steam library. In the last holiday sale, I'd purchased every Max Payne game for the PC. If there was one character I identified with, it was definitely this washout ex-cop and his penchant to survive despite all odds. The only thing I didn't really care for was the slow motion and bullet time, but you learn to embrace it in this series. The real reason I'd purchased the bundle was because of the third game, the aptly titled Max Payne 3. A gem of third-person shooters that I think doesn't get enough credit for being a fantastic piece of work. Sure, it was pulling in almost perfect scores, but the game's mix of excellent soundtrack, heart-pumping action, and Oscar-worthy storytelling gave films like Man on Fire and Road to Perdition a run for their money. A neo-noir comic book-style story of a man past his prime, trying to unfuck everything about his past life, only to enter a brand new one and make it worse than the last. Max is just the kind of thick bastard that everything he touches turns into slow-motion bullet hell with an incredible amounts of gore. In this man, I see a kindred spirit. He, an ex-cop, with worse luck than a leprechaun with leprosy. And in me, an ex-military cop, who had one too many bouts of bad luck, only to end up getting tossed out right on his ass. Unlike him, though, I'm not addicted to painkillers and booze. Max Payne 3 plays like a major summer blockbuster, and can be beaten in just under 8 hours. I wouldn't waste my money on the season pass, however. Multiplayer's pretty much all dried up. With the release of GTA 5, most of Rockstar's player base for Max Payne 3 went over to the other game. This game has plenty of reason to replay, though. Every level has several parts to golden versions of the guns in the game, hidden in nooks and crannies. Some more obvious than others. On top of that, there are countless clues that help you better understand the entire story, down to the minutiae. It all depends on how much of a detective you care to be, and how much of this game you want to experience. Max Payne is one of those series that I learned to love. Also, it's a game series that was known for being incredibly hard prior to this entry. If I have one complaint, it's that this game's easy and normal modes are pretty much a joke. The best way to play it is on hard or above. Maybe it's because I'm playing with a mouse and keyboard now as opposed to the PlayStation 2 controller when I played the first two games. Maybe my skill in games is just better. Who can say? What I do know is that I like my Max Payne like I like my Dark Souls. Ball-crushingly hard and rage-inducing. Well, that's all really I have to say on the matter for now. Need to climb back into myself and focus back on the pastel ponies and the magic of friendship. Leave the gritty, blood-soaked streaks of Sao Paulo behind me. Besides, if I want to see a grimdark tragedy set in Brazil, I'll turn on the TV and tune into the 2016 Olympics. Christ, at least Max Payne 3 has a decent ending. One that doesn't end up with the US rowing team getting used syringes stuck in their forearms after going through a bad swell of good old Brazilian sewage-laden river water. I've been the Jester Pony Foolery. Taddy bye, fuckboys and fuckers.